and internal price referencing for generics and other products within the same therapeutic classes. And we set profit control for local agent and for pharmacy action. So for innovative drug, for faster drug, as we know, we are the second or third country in the world, so we cannot use the external price referencing. Instead, we request undertaking letter from market authorization holder to provide MOH with any price changes in the country of origin, or for example, if that medicine registered in any other country, they have to provide the pricing certificate. And the external price referencing will be used for repricing or price reviewing or at the registration renewal. And the external price referencing might consider the mean, median, or lowest price, take in consideration other factors in the referenced country. This is, I mean, this is a general term, not for the innovative drug, okay? And for example, we count for this innovative drug the ex-factory price and the retail price in the country of origin, and if it is registered in any other developed country. The milestone in the pricing system in the UAE, we conduct, I mean, in the introduction for my colleague, Dr. Nadia. Dr. Nadia was working with us in the Ministry of Health in the drug department, the regulator, and we worked together in conducting this study, and we conduct in 2010 and comparing the CIF price among Saudi Arabia, Oman and Jordan and other two countries, and we find in comparison to Saudi Arabia, maybe 85% of pharmaceutical priced in the UAE were the CIF higher than Saudi Arabia. And after that, based on that study, we start the Ministry of Health, the price reduction initiative, and it's a voluntary initiative, and the pharmaceutical industry, they collaborate with Ministry of Health. So two waves, it was in 2011, and the third wave, it was in 2013. Then the new pricing system being implemented in 2013, in line with the GCC price harmonization, dollarization, and CIF unification. Then the study, which is I just covered the survey, it's been also in the first quarter in 2014. And the price reduction initiative wave, it was in 2014, and the price reduction initiative wave, fifth wave, it was in 22nd January 2015. So the current pricing system, now all the CIF price are in US dollar in line with the dollarization of the GCC, and the medicines are categorized in three categories as per the CIF price, and this is its impact the pharmacy margin. So the first category is the CIF equal or below 250 dirham, and the CIF between 250 to 500 dirham, and CIF above 500 dirham. So the pharmacy margin will decrease as the CIF increases. So the total margin for the medicine, any medicine in the UAE priced medicine, it's ranged from 35 to 43%. The wholesaler or local agent margin have a flat margin. It's 15% from the CIF price, which is equal to 11% for the wholesale price selling to the pharmacies. And the pharmacy margin ranged from 17 to 24. So 24% it's for the lowest CIF price. We use the ex-factory price as equal for substitute for CIF price for imported medicine. The CIF dollar unification and dollarization, it will be covered by my colleague Dr. Mohamed Rubeiri. However, it was approved in 2007, and the main objective is to unify CIF export price of medicine to all GCC countries as per the lowest price, and most likely it's Saudi Arabia. And all CIF are in US dollar, and the markup from CIF, it should not increase 45%. However, as you might know, I don't know, I was a member for a group purchase tender for more than 14 years in the GCC. All this GCC tender, it was by US dollar for all GCC countries, and one price, CIF, or one price, warehouse to warehouse, it will be the offer by any pharmaceutical company or any consumer supplier. And And based on that, it was recommendation that why, and also one of the requirement, it's any bidder who should mention the registered price in all GCC country where it's registered. And during that tender, we used to notice the big variation between the prices between Saudi Arabia and other, like UAE and Kuwait and Oman. So it was raised at that time recommendation. However, other recommendation also raised in Bahrain to support this initiative for CIF unification and dollarization. So now we are moving to last part of this presentation. It's about, are we ready to use economic evaluation as decision-making tool? Of course, the new methodology now is value-based pricing, which is implemented in developed country, and the system evaluating new pharmaceutical and establishing a maximum price based on clinical effectiveness and other factors. It's increasingly common in healthcare system worldwide. So this system, it's, I mean, I think it's the ideal for developed country and for countries with high income. Yesterday, Dr. Amer, he mentioned about that, yes, if we go for just, we focus on the value, it will increase the price. And also, when we implement health technology assessment, it's also increase the price. And maybe this is the ideal to support the innovation worldwide in high-income country and in developed country. So the other methodology which is promoted